A 20-million-ton algae bloom is lingering off the coast of Florida.
It's actually one of the biggest experts have ever seen. The massive mass stretches all the way from West Africa to the Caribbean. Right now, it's pushing heaps of seaweed onto beaches along Florida's east coast. NBC2's Devin Turk talked to experts to find out if we could start seeing the same thing along our coastline. He's live on the Sanibel Causeway tonight.
Well, Sean, the water right now in the Sanibel Causeway looks fantastic. This is nothing like what we saw last year right around this time. But scientists do warn millions of tons of that algae are out there in the Gulf. And if the wind changes, we could see it on our beaches.
While Southwest Florida beaches are looking clear,
it looks beautiful. Great day. A lot of people out in the water.
Thousands of pounds of a brown algae called sargassum seaweed is taking over and stinking up beaches on Florida's east coast and the Keys.
It doesn't help the tourist dollars that come down here for summer, that's for sure.
University of South Florida scientists are monitoring what they call one of the biggest algae blooms ever, 20 million tons from West Africa to the Gulf of Mexico. FGCU's Dr. James Douglas says he's worried about what this means for our nearshore ecosystem.
When there are big rotting clumps of it, it releases its nutrients into the water, and those nutrients can cause other harmful algae blooms, can hurt seagrasses and coral reefs, and that's also bad for the tourism.
Dr. Douglas says the seaweed has always been found in tropical waters, but there's been more in recent years than ever before.
Because there's so much nutrients now entering the ocean through the atmosphere and river discharges like the Mississippi and the Amazon, that now nutrient pollution is reaching the open ocean where the sargassum grows.
It typically avoids our area because of prevailing winds, but as an avid windsurfer, he says he's seen it out in the Gulf.
Well, I know it's out here, not so far off our coasts. All it would take would be a change in the winds to have this start washing up on our coast.
And Dr. Douglas does say clumps of it can be used for compost. He said we need to reduce the global nutrient problem that fuels this. Reporting live in the Sanibel Causeway, Devin Turk, NBC2.